carpets of sound. And then I remembered all those times in houses that I was taken to and the bazaar in Tehran, and how I would stare at the Persian carpets and actually find the discrepancies in the patterns. So the, my first approach was to take classical music, for as the Persian language, which is extraordinarily rich, and I think one of the greatest things that the Persians have given to humanity is their poetry. For example, the word heart has 40 different definitions and 40 different words to describe. Classical music gives you every range of emotion. So by studying classical music, in a sense collaging classical music, in this case, these two works are based on Mahler's Fifth, I take the samples and then I tune them into the Daskal, like Tishur or Naval, which gives it an extra emotional, that emotional resonance. There's already a calm and sort of meditative feeling that is produced from my work that was a byproduct, that wasn't really something that I had set out to do. And then in this situation, I take a composition and then I split it into two equal fragments, so that when they play together, they're not cacophonous and they can keep playing to create new patterns as it goes. These are just the first housing, and they sort of are reminiscent of old Persian arts, from Persian miniatures to the inlays, to the cigar boxes, to the little pen cases, and the obsessiveness of just working and working a surface. The work now expanded, and I think this is actually the best I've ever shown them, because the work that I'm making now is very reminiscent, nowhere near the epicness, if I could ever reach this, this house. But the work now is more, includes light and music, and they're based on the structure of the ear. So you literally, you walk in and you can experience this sound as a physical entity.